Hey all guys, it's Fisher, and welcome back to some more Telltale's Game of Thrones action, episode 1. So I feel like this is going to be the last part. I'm pretty sure there's not much more left for us to do. We've literally just left King's Landing, and now we're with Geralt and going on the way to the Wall. I'm having a lot of fun with this game, I really, really am. I think they've done a brilliant job, and it's kind of got me pumped for Season 5 even more, especially because this will run up to Season 5, and hopefully you'll be able to interact maybe with Stannis or something. It's going to be really, really awesome. But yeah, let's go ahead and get back in. We're all currently on the King's Road. Making our way to the Wall. That never sounds too good. And we've lost our horse. It's never a good start, really, is it?
Seven elves.
Oh, some dude getting flayed.
Let's play a little game, shall we?
That was Ramsay Bolton. Sick.
Did you know my ancestors wore the skins of their enemies as a coat?
Can we just leave?
Not my best work, unfortunately. I suppose I have full enough practice. But he didn't make it easy. What with all that bloody noise?
Like a drowning cat. I thought he'd never stop.
As my father likes to say, a naked man holds few secrets. But the flayed man holds none.
Pity he didn't know your father was the Warden of the North.
He does now.
He definitely does now.
How much further is it to these foresters?
A day, my lord. Two at most.
What was that?
My lord?
Shh! Listen.
Is he gonna like try to hunt us down? As long as we get to the Wall, we'll be safe. We'll be protected by the Night's Watch.
I know I heard something.
I'll stay still, maybe he won't see me. Running would just make it too obvious.
Never mind.
Yeah, exactly.
We've wasted enough time.
He would have probably started off hunting us or something if we decided to run there. Guess let's go look at this dude who's just been sliced up. I guess. I bet you he comes back though. Oh, this guy's gonna have like his chest just split open. It's gonna be grim.
Bloody hell.
Oh, that's disgusting. R.I.P. his chest. Oh, we're back in Iron Wrath. I guess we'll go ahead. Maybe learn to fight some swords, maybe?
As I was saying, you are young. And there are those within these walls who are uncertain of your leadership. But 300 generations of Forrester lords stand behind you. Lord Gerhard the Tall, who founded our house, and your grandfather, Lord Thorin the Bold, who seized back the river valley from the White Hills.
What did they call my father?
Lord Gregor the Good. He was fair and wise and courageous in battle.
What do they call me?
That is for you to define as the new lord. These were your father's people to lead and protect, and now they're yours. But your father did not bear this responsibility alone. He and every Forrester Lord before him chose one man whom they trusted above all others, the Lord Sentinel. Forrester traditions demand that a new Lord Sentinel must be chosen.
Keep walking, you craven son of a whore. Move! Summon the Lord! We need his judgment!
I've done nothing wrong! I was only trying to survive!
Lord Ethan. Maester.
Who is this man?
This craven is a deserter and a thief.
This house is doomed! We all fucking know it!
Quiet, thief. Eric was supposed to be guarding our weapons, but instead we caught him stealing them.
Two shields and three spears.
Why did you do it?
Because I've no wish to die. Yes, my lord. I fled. We should all flee.
He needs to be executed.
You've taken what's yours by right.
He speaks truth.
I've a family to feed. And not two coins to rub together since Lord Gregor left us to rot here. Where's our pay? Our share of bread and wine grows smaller every day.
Leave the poor man alone.
Mercy.
Lord Ethan, I know these words are hard, but they're honest. This house is falling. We'll never survive the coming winter.
Calm yourself and you admit you're a criminal. Together we'll survive.
Live to see it.
Calm yourself.
The time for calm passed with the late Lord Forrester. Now there's only chaos.
You'll address him as Lord. Lord Ethan, you must decide the punishment. Lord Gregor always took a thief's fingers. Three of them.
Now may not be the time for harsh punishment. The men are on edge as it is.
The men need to know they cannot do whatever the fuck they please. Their lord will not permit it.
He's a thief.
We can send him to the war.
Leave the man alone. Show him mercy, my lord. He stole from us. He deserves it. Make him pay for what he's done. Give us justice.
Fuck him. I will decide.
Send him to the war.
Leave the poor man.
Take his fingers.
He's a thief. If you punish me, you'll be punishing an innocent man. It will be an injustice, my lord. Please.
Oh shit, what do we do?
My family depends.
Show him
on
mercy, send him to the wall, take three fingers. Well, he is a criminal, so we have to show him just. We have to be just here. He is a criminal. I can't show him mercy, so it's either send him to the wall or take his fingers. I guess send him to the wall because they need every man they can get with the coming invasion.
I sentence you to the wall where you will join the Night's Watch.
No, please, my lord! My family, without me, they'll die!
It's unfortunate, but it has to happen. Like, he's a thief, he's a criminal. I can't show him justice. I have to be just. That was justice. I guess we should go talk to her now, maybe?
That was certainly unpleasant, but a lord must mete out punishment when it's due.
Exactly.
Not just yourself, of course.
It was my duty.
It's a lord's duty, so I did it.
You heard what the thief said. I expect this sort of thing will happen again. But a sentinel can help you in the face of disloyalty. You need someone you can trust by your side. Someone you can rely on. No matter the circumstance, possessing wisdom and experience.
Who do you think I should choose?
There are two capable men for the role. They both want the job, but neither thinks very highly of the other.
How do I decide between them?
Talk to them. Solicit the opinion of people close to you. Here, the bracer of the Sentinel, the badge of office. Tonight is your first small council meeting. It would be wise to bestow this bracer upon your chosen sentinel then, to show that you are decisive and in control of this house. Your sentinel will wear this for all to see.
Thank you. I think I'm going to go with a Castellan, because
it is my duty.
Because he knows about
speak with me when you're ready to convene the small council, my lord.
because he knows about the whatever Mott, I can't remember its actual name, but the secret we only told him. So I feel like he's like the smartest man, whereas that guy is just way too rash. Like, he's a good fighter, of course, but I feel like we need smart men at this time, not men who are dedicated for war, because technically we're not actually at war anymore. Well, we're technically at war with, like, Stannis, but, yeah, so let's go and talk to this guy first. Ooh, food. Let's go and talk to Duncan.
Duncan.
Yes, my lord.
Let's see what he has to say.
Consider and face a difficult decision.
Perhaps I can help. Your father often sought my counsel.
As Lord, I must name a sentinel.
Of course. And if I may ask, who do you favor for the role? Perhaps I can share my insight. And talking can sometimes help you make a decision.
Actually, I wanted to ask, why did you send Garrett away?
I did it for your own protection, my lord. Garrett had to go. By sending him away myself, I thought it would keep you blameless in the eyes of the White Hills. I only hope to give you an advantage.
Yeah, I understand.
And you're forgiven.
Thank you, my lord.
Thank you, Duncan. I appreciate your advice.
I'm at your service, my lord.
Can we talk to him some more? There was some... Give a brace, just look at him. Let's go ahead and check out his food. Maybe I can, like, distribute it a bit better. Or can we not even get him there? No, but looks like we can't even get him there.
Our provisions are rather low, my lord. I made the count again, just to be sure. But it doesn't look good.
How bad is it? How long could we hold the house?
We couldn't withstand a siege, my lord. If the Boltons or the White Hills cut us off and wait us out, we'd only last a fortnight.
That's not good.
There are steps we can take. In the past, we've demanded food from the small folk to replenish our stores. We can do it again, if you'd like. We've done it before in desperate times. The last long winter, my family had to give all our pigs to the house.
Yeah. I trust you to make the right decision.
We'll have to take food from the small folk and hope they can fend for themselves. If the house falls, they'd all be worse for it.
Yeah, at the end of the day, that is right.
The arrangements, my lord.
Yeah. Okay, cool. So we're getting food from the small folk. Obviously, I don't like doing it, but if the house falls, then we all fall. So, enter the tower.
Now, when I say parry, get that sword out.
Let's go and look at the shield. The shield of House Forrester. Does look pretty cool. Let's go and talk to Rion.
Careful.
Our brother.
Keep at it and you won't have much left. Something to pick your teeth with.
No, Ethan. Look at this. All good swords have a name. I call mine Two Brothers.
Like the game.
I carve this to give me strength. And this, so I remember. I mean, I could never forget. But, you know, don't you?
You honor Roderick with this. He was a strong one.
He was. Yeah. Someday, I'll have a real one. But not like that one. Only a lord could have that sword.
You'll have a good sword. I'm sure of it.
I watched you today. I saw what you did to that man. Was he... our enemy, a bad man. Everyone keeps talking about them.
Rules mean nothing if we don't enforce them. It doesn't matter if he's good or bad. You can't steal. That's a rule.
That is the rule.
I say he was bad. Bad men killed Father and Roderick. They need someone to hurt them back. Even worse. I want a real sword. No one's afraid of wood. I'll find the men who took Roderick someday, and I'll make sure I have a real sword when I do.
Well, he's a bit angry. Let's go talk to... Who do we want to talk to? We want to talk to my sister now. She's around here somewhere. Yeah, there she is, by the horses. We talk to her or not? Because she looked very disapproving. I guess we can't talk to her. Let's talk to Malcolm.
Ethan. Or should I say Lord Ethan?
Hello, Uncle Malcolm.
I saw what you did today. It's not an easy thing to do. showing mercy to a man who admits his guilt. But if you'll excuse me, my lord, I should finish packing before nightfall. I hope to be off tomorrow.
Where are you going?
First light.
But where are you going?
Your mother asked me to cross the narrow sea to find your brother, Asher.
Asher?
Ah, cool.
She has asked me to return with him, to help the house.
She said nothing of this to me.
Because she fears you will not agree. I told her my place is here, that I'll be of no help to you in Essos. But she insisted. I will hold, of course, until you've spoken with her about this. Just try to be kind to her. She's been living a nightmare made real. But you know that just as well.
She's my mother. I know how to speak to her.
I'm sure you do.
But my mother's fears are not the only ones I face. My people are scared as well. I'm told I must choose a sentinel.
If I may be so bold, Sir Roiland is the man for the job. He'd be a fine choice. And I'd trust him. Aye, Sir Roiland is the man you want.
Why Sir Roiland?
We are at war. You need a warrior by your side. Roiland has the respect of his men and will bring strength and discipline to this house. Duncan would offer sage advice, but now is not the time to negotiate. Not the likes of Ramsay Snow.
Thank you, Uncle.
We have to negotiate,
Ethan,
I think.
I need to talk to you.
I think I'm going to have to go with the negotiator, because we have to be diplomatic at the current situation. We currently hold no...
Mira has asked for Lady Marjorie's help.
Did she?
I knew we could rely on Mira. She always thinks of family above all else. Hopefully Lady Marjorie's influence will be enough. But right now I'm more concerned about you. I saw what you did to that man. You promised me you wouldn't change, and I believed you.
I can't afford any more mistakes. Everyone knows what happened with Lord Whitehill. Garrod being sent to the wall without my knowledge.
I know, and that wasn't your fault.
I'm the Lord. It's my responsibility. The people want me to lead. They need me to, but...
What? Ethan, please.
What would you do? I wish Father was here.
I wish Father were here.
We all do, but Father's gone. You are the Lord of this house, which is why you must be strong. You're just as capable as Asher or Roderick ever were. I know it. I only wish you did too.
You've always given me good advice. Thank you.
I still don't know who to choose. I'm still going to go talk to Lord Roderick. But I personally still think I'm just going to talk to the other dude because we aren't at war. Like, we're on the brink of war, but we're not... I don't know.
Sword up! Swing left! Parry! Wrong! I didn't know
Sir
dogs
Roiland.
Could hold swords.
A word?
Of course, my lord.
I have many decisions to make, and I wanted your advice. What's the state of our defences? Are these men ready for what's coming?
This lot, ready? No, but they will be. We post anyone who can hold a spear along the parapet, up where they won't get much scrutiny, and put our meanest, nastiest-looking brutes front and centre. That'll show Ramsay we're a force in our own right. You've got to project power, especially when you're weakened.
Thank you, Sir Roiland. I'll let you get back to training these men.
Thank you, my lord.
Oh, I don't know who to choose.
I'll be sure to watch out for more deserters. After today, I suspect there'll be more to come.
Oh, who the fuck do I choose? Is there anyone else to talk to? Are you talking to? Can I talk to you? I guess not. Let's look at...
Are you holding a sword or a turkey leg?
Okay, cool. So let's think about this. I either choose him, he's a strong leader, but I feel like he's a bit rash. The men will respect him and be ready to go into battle for him. But are we going to be fighting, like, much at the moment? Would it be better to have more diplomatic? He seems to think... Is anyone to talk to over here? Let's go ahead and talk to the maester quickly.
Slash right.
Yeah, let's... Let's see what the Maester thinks. Because I'm going with the diplomatic route. I think the other guy will be better as my sentinel. Maester. Let's see what the Maester has to say.
I see you've spoken to a number of people. Are you prepared to name your sentinel?
What is your
perspective? What is it you're doing over here?
Admiring the ironwood, my lord. I studied it at the Citadel. The wood may be black, but I see gold. An entire forest of gold.
What do you mean?
It is our greatest asset, my lord. Why not give some of our ironwood to House Bolton and have them leave us be? We could ransom ourselves. You can hardly put a price on your own life, or the lives of those you love.
How much do we have to give, Maester?
From here to Wolfswood Creek and then across the next two ridges, it should be enough to satisfy Ramsay Snow, I imagine. Bloodlust can often be sated by gifts and gold.
You're all worthless!
Okay, so he wants us to enter the tower. Let's see what's up here. So he seems to want us to have to give away everything. I still have to choose my two sentinels as well. I'm just seeing what's up here, really. There could be nothing up here. I guess you just get to look at everything. It's kind of cool. Let's go ahead and go back down. Oh, this is such a hard decision because I know it's going to really come back and hurt me. So Roderick or... I guess we are at war. Because I obviously don't want to give up what's ours. I'm choosing with diplomacy. I'm going to go ahead and give a brace to Duncan. Duncan.
I've decided to name you as my sentinel. Congratulations.
Why, thank you, my lord. I'm honored. But are you sure?
No, I'm not. Yes, I am.
Yes, of course. I'm convinced you're the man for the job.
Then I accept. But first, you must summon the small council, my lord, to make it official.
Right. I'll tell Maester Ortengren to do it at once.
I feel like we need a diplomatic head at this time. We're not going to be at war. We're going to bend the knee to Ramsay Snow, obviously, until Stannis comes along.
You can lift them, yeah?
Even though I think the other guy would be very, very good. I don't know. I'm kind of conflicted.
My lord, are you now ready to name your sentinel?
I literally am like 50-50% on who to pick.
I'm ready.
Very well. I will convene the small council at once.
Literally am 50-50. I'm not sure who I should have chosen. But I think... I don't know. I feel like this is actually like a major decision as well. Especially when Ramsay comes along. I really don't want to give up any of my ironwood either, because that's kind of what makes us strong.
You may sit.
I believe Lord Ethan has reached his decision.
Before I name my sentinel, I must tell you.
The choice was clear.
Duncan, Roiland, this house needs you both.
But you can only choose one, my lord.
No.
Be on with it.
Many thought either of you would make a fine sentinel, but I have made my decision.
Duncan.
Duncan Tuttle, you will be my sentinel.
Tuttle? This is reckless.
Lord Ethan has made his choice. I will not disappoint you, my lord.
He's a good man. I'm just kind of scared that Roiland has
sentinel,
the
what
troops.
Do you have to report of Ramsay Snow?
Our scouts say he's only a day's ride from here. We've no time to waste.
Who knows what he's capable of? We need to prepare for the worst.
We can devise a plan to deal with him.
The Boltons need our people to harvest the ironwood. Even the bastard Ramsay must understand that.
He's not coming here to negotiate. We must answer with the sword. That's bloody suicide. You gamble with the lives of everyone within these walls.
Ignore Sir Roiland. You named me Sentinel. I knew this would happen. He cannot be trusted.
This is the bloody small council.
Stop bickering.
Enough! Would my father have stood for this kind of bickering? Neither will I.
Sir Roiland is clearly able and ready to take up arms, but the rest of our soldiers are not. We need to take a cunning approach.
Yeah, exactly. Diplomacy. I like that.
A sharper instrument than a sword.
The Bolton Sigil is a flayed man. Force is the only thing they understand.
Gentlemen, please. Thank the gods Mira has asked Lady Marjorie for her help. It's not too late for the Crown to intervene on our behalf. But we must have a plan if Mira's efforts are not successful. I trust Mira's judgment. I don't doubt she did everything within her power to help
we
us.
We must unify.
You must make your opinion known.
Oh, crap. Oh, I meant to click that.
Why not make an offering for peace?
I miss
the wisdom of
Oh,
we can give the Boltons iron in exchange for their protection.
You must be mad. It's pure folly to just give away the only currency we have to
bargain. Yeah, I agree with that. We will bargain. We'll be diplomatic.
My new sentinel favors a certain approach, and I agree. I shall use diplomacy with Lord Snow. I would be foolish to pick a fight without negotiating first. I'll offer our allegiance and try to reach a reasonable agreement.
If you aren't ready for a fight, you're bound to lose when one breaks out.
Ethan has made his opinion known, and you will respect his decision.
Forgive us, my lord. We are, of course, here to serve you, as we served your father.
Aye.
Well then, let's decide how we shall set the stage for Ramsay's arrival. Invite him into this hall, and meet him face to face, lord to lord.
Ramsay Snow is no lord. That's absurd. You meet him at the gate with as much force as we can muster. Make him wait. Let him gaze upon Ironwrath. And when he enters, he'll know it's only because you allowed it.
Lord Ethan?
Ah, oh, so many decisions. I will invite Ramsay into the Great Hall. I will make Ramsay wait at the gate. Well, I really don't want to piss him off. Fuck. Some hard decisions. Let's go ahead and invite him into the Great Hall.
I will meet him in the Great Hall.
A wise move, my lord.
It's careless. Can't you see Tuttle is steering you wrong?
That's enough, Roiland. Lord Ethan has given his command.
How many years have I served this house? I cannot listen to that bloody idiot anymore. Forgive me, my lord, but you are not ready to be lord of this house. You're likely to get us all killed.
Sit down at once.
Apologies, my son. But now that it is settled, we know what we must do. You will meet Ramsay Snow in the Great Hall, and we will not offer our ironwood.
No, of course we will not.
And don't worry, Lord Ethan.
It is ours.
We'll stand beside you, where your sentinel belongs.
Then perhaps we should adjourn. We have to prepare the house.
My lord, I have fought for this family for many years. Do not forget that.
I guess we'll talk to our mother about Asher now.
There will always be those who question your leadership, which is why you need allies you can rely on. Family. Mira has done everything she can in King's Landing, but there are others who can help us. What about your brother, Asher?
Malcolm told me. You want to bring him back.
He's a skilled fighter. But what's more, he has the will to fight. A hunger for it. He always protected you and your sister. And we need all the help we can get.
But won't he be lord if he returns? Do you want him to take my place?
Of course not. He has no interest in such things. And that's not what I want either. Asher is volatile. But that is his strength, too. Do you remember the miller's boy? How he tormented you? I wanted to intervene, but your father said Ethan must fight his own battles. But when Asher saw it, he didn't take a breath. He grabbed the Miller's boy by the neck. That was his first instinct. Asher knocked out half the poor boy's teeth. Of course, your father was furious, but you were in danger and there was nothing else Asher needed to know.
He seems like a nice guy.
He acts, and we need that. You have many fine qualities, but you do not have that anger inside you.
I'm not like that, but I don't need to be, do I?
No, but you need someone who is standing beside you.
Yeah, I think it's good to take him back.
I'm trying to do what's best for this family, what this family needs. Ethan, let me send Malcolm to Essos.
Yes, you can go. Send him to Essos. Fine.
Malcolm will go to Essos and bring Asher back.
Thank you, Ethan. I'm glad you will let me do this. Know that you never stand alone. You are a forester. Mira stands with us, and she may be able to help us yet.
Hopefully she's helped us. I wonder if we actually get to do our thing with Ramsay Snow or not. Back to King's Landing. Okay, guys, so I'm going to go ahead and end the episode here. I hope you're enjoying this as much as I am. I thought it was almost over, but apparently not. I guess there's still more to... go ahead and play. So yeah, if you enjoyed this, please do go ahead and like and subscribe, and also comment in the section down below. Also, if you've done something different to me up to this point, and you've seen the effect up to this point, please go ahead and tell me in the comments. Tell me if you've chose a different sentinel to me, if that affected you a bit in the small council. Obviously, don't ruin anything for me and tell me, oh, I did this, so now this is going to happen. However, I hope you enjoyed, and fish out.